so that you may know what is happening here at St. Mary Parish. There are still lucky lottery numbers available for this year's contest. Each three-digit number is $40 and is good from the day received until December 31st. To purchase your number, contact Sandy in the Parish Office Center. Please help us reach our goal of selling all 1,000 numbers. 2022 Lucky Lottery calendar should be arriving this week. A flock note will be sent out when the calendars are ready for pickup, either in the back of church or at the Parish Office Center. St. Mary's school families will have their calendars sent home with their students. The calendar will be posted on the parish website, and you can check there for any prize information beginning on Monday, February 14th. Thank you for your patience. At this time, let us bow our heads in prayer to Our Lady of Guadalupe on behalf of our country and our world for a complete end to the coronavirus pandemic. Holy Virgin of Guadalupe, Queen of the Angels and Mother of the Americas, we fly to you today as your beloved children. We ask you to intercede for us with your Son, as you did at the wedding in Cana. Pray for us, loving Mother, and aim for our nation and world, and for all our families and loved ones, the protection of your holy angels, that we may be spared the worst of this illness. For those already afflicted, we ask you to obtain the grace of healing and deliverance. Hear the cries of those who are vulnerable and fearful. Wipe away their tears and help them to trust. In this time of trial and testing, teach all of us in the church to love one another and to be patient and kind. Help us to bring the peace of Jesus to our land and to our hearts. We come to you with confidence, knowing that you truly are our compassionate Mother, help of the sick and cause of our joy. Shelter us under the mantle of your protection. Keep us in the embrace of your arms. Help us always to know the love of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Today is the sixth Sunday in Ordinary Time. This Mass is being offered for Carl Lee and Rita Keyes Hinson, requested by their children, Deacon Ed and Peggy Hinson. Our celebrant is Father Bellapini, assisted by Deacon Don Nichols. Our entrance hymn is number 303, Breaking Bread, Gather Us In, number 303.
To Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned ministry, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thus says the Lord, cursed is the one who trusts in human beings, who seeks its strength in flesh, whose heart turns away from the Lord, is like a barren bush in the desert, that enjoys no change of season, but stands in a lava waste, is salt and empty earth. Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose hope is the Lord. He is like a tree planted beside the waters that stretches out its roots to the stream. It fears not the heat when it comes. Its leaves stay green. In the year of drought, it shows no distress, but still bears fruit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if Christ is preached as raised from the dead, how can some among you say there is no resurrection of the dead? If the dead are not raised, neither has Christ been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is vain. You are still in your sins. Then those who have fallen asleep in Christ have perished. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are the most pitiable people of all. But now Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
God is yours. Blessed are you who are now hungry, for you will be satisfied. Blessed are you who are now weeping, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude and insult you, and denounce your name as evil on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice and leap for joy on that day. Behold, your reward will be great in heaven. For their ancestors treated the prophets in the same way. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are filled now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who laugh now, for you will grieve and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for their ancestors treated the false prophets in this way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Christianity is a paradox, is it not? To die, absolutely, all of us will die, but in that death, we will rise. There is sin, but it doesn't end that way. In our life, there is grace, and so the choosing, the will that struggles between good and evil. Today we hear Luke's explanation of the great sermon. We're familiar with the Sermon on the Mount from Matthew's Gospel. Today Luke gives us his perspective. And it has a very much of a striking punch to it. It's also teaching us about the paradox of life. Blessed or happy are those who are mourning, or poor, or hungry, or weeping. Lord, why are they happy? Why would you advocate those feelings? And yet you say, woe to those who are rich. Woe to you who laugh. Woe to you who speak well of you. Lord, are we to be in misery here? Why would you advocate those kind of sentiments among your people? When we understand what Jesus is teaching, we could say to ourselves, absolutely correct, Lord. You are teaching us. Because we are to be united with Christ not by our own intellect, but by our will, our decisions. We're to be grafted to him by virtue of our baptism. And we are to be dependent on him. Now, that's nice to say, but does it actually happen? Well, sure. The whole part of the journey of discipleship is to be dependent on God. Not to be an island unto ourselves. Not to do everything by ourselves as if we're going to take care of this. We don't need God. I don't want to bother God. I don't want to keep on asking him. I don't want to just tell him I can't do it. I think that's the work of the devil. depend on God, but to depend on myself would certainly be an egoism I want to avoid. Why? Because it bespeaks pride, which is a capital sin. And if you look at pride, you will see how it's a downfall to the spiritual life. Look at our lives. Look at the times that we have depended on ourselves and our own pride and not go to God and be joined to Him, to be dependent on Him. I think sometimes we think that's a negative, to be dependent on somebody. You know, when we grow older, we don't want to be dependent on somebody. We don't want to ask them for help. We don't want to bother our children now that they're grown. They have their own responsibility. Let me do this by myself. And what happens? We fall physically because we can't make it to the couch, to the kitchen. We hit our head. We go into rooms that we don't know why we went into those rooms. We're forgetful. Our mind is forgetful of things. And our children, our adult children, said, "Mom, Dad, why don't you call me?" Do you see how we're all children of God and how He is asking us for that relationship that we are granted to Him, just like in a way that we are granted to our parents because we came from them. But we come from God, all of us, and we need to be dependent on them. It's when we're not that all the other things become our source of energy, our source of pride, and they become our gods. Does God want us to be poor? Not really. Does He want us to be rich? Not necessarily. What does He want then? Well, He wants us to be dependent on Him no matter what we have. Maybe you've been blessed with a very good job. Does that mean not to take care of my responsibility and use my resources properly? Absolutely not. But to make sure that all of that does not become a source of pride, that it becomes a big, inflated ego, that now I have my own kingdom. I don't need God. Why do you think those Negro spirituals are so beautiful? Because they have nothing, and their song and their conversation is all about God. They sing about amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Because they have nothing, but what they do have makes them so rich because they have God. Sometimes all of these things that we can accumulate in and of themselves, they're not sinful, but once we gravitate toward them and make them part of our life and they're granted to us, it becomes sinful because we're not dependent on God, we're dependent on these things. And that's why He says, "Blessed are you who are poor, because you're dependent on Me for the riches." But if you're rich, well, you have your God. You don't need Me, because you think to yourself, this is what's going to make me happy. I have the best of clothes, the best of houses, the best car. I have all my gadgets and all my toys. I'm content. I don't really need God. Once I get sick, maybe then I'll start praying. Maybe if my wife or my husband or my mother or father gets ill or there's a tragedy, then God, I'll be dependent on You. But other than that, I'll put you aside for now because I have all my other toys. I have things to really make me happy. That's why He says all of these things. So when you go back during the week and you're praying your night prayers, take out the gospel again. Take the gospel for Sunday and just make that your week of prayer, because you can allow it to digest more and more as you read it maybe before Mass began today. And that's always a good thing when you come into church and you kneel down and say a prayer before Mass begins. Quickly open the Breaking Bread book, go to the gospel, read the passage of the gospel, and then we'll stand and we'll celebrate Mass. You'll have it heard, you've read it already once, and it'll be sinking into your heart to think of what God is speaking to you personally. How beautiful, even in the first reading, did you hear from the book of the prophet Jeremiah? Cursed is the one who trusts in human beings, who seeks his strength in flesh. Even Jeremiah was talking about that. How beautiful Jesus fulfills the Old Testament. So to all you lovebirds, happy Valentine's Day tomorrow. It's a nice day just to recommit yourself to a beautiful sentiment of love. So all of us know that we're married to God. We've been grafted to him in baptism. So there has already been a nuptial in your life. It was on the day of your baptism. How beautiful that is. And God, in his goodness, calls all of us, whether we're single or married or celibate or deacon or priest, to be in a relationship with him as the groom, and we're the bride. So we have a nuptial going on. And how beautiful he calls men and women to mirror the nuptial he has with his people. Isn't that nice? I think it's beautiful that God calls men and women and say, here, mirror what I have already done for my people. I'm already married to them. I'm wedded to them in an unbreakable bond. But I'm going to call men and women to reflect this kind of love. For better, here's a paradox. For better or for worse. For richer or for poor. In sickness or in health. Do you see the paradox again in the Christian life? That God establishes all of this among his people. And he allows the married couple to mirror a love that is not of this world, but of the next. I hope all married couples and those preparing for marriage understand that. It is to mirror a transcendent love and not an earthly love. And yet he allows us to engage in the nuptial here on earth to another person so as to reflect in this world the nuptial he has with his people. I hope people get that. I do. I hope people really understand that the marriage is just not courted among these two people and has nothing to do with the purpose of matrimony. Maybe you missed the point. But if you understand the purpose of it, just like the gospel today, right? If we understand it, then we can live it properly, because in light of him. And we kind of die. We kind of die to live each day. Even nature dies and we wake up. Even the person sleeps. They kind of die and then we're awoken up again. Winter and then summer. There's a whole natural flow in nature as well as with human beings. So tomorrow, as we celebrate Valentine's Day, first give thanks to God and thank him for the nuptial that has been given to you personally. And then thank him for introducing him to your spouse, to be a reflection of this world, in this world, of his great love. And marriage is just for this world, so that it prepares us for the next. Because he's the bridegroom, and we're the bride. second reading from St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians is about that death and rising, isn't it? So the whole text this weekend is about the paradox. May you and I enter into this Eucharist understanding that. And may we always be reminded that we need to die to pride so as to live a life of virtue. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God,
born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. God, the Holy Spirit, was in the mind of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, who is crucified on a conscious pilot, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting in God, who sent his only Son for our salvation, let's offer him our prayers.
For the Church, may the Lord strengthen her in her mission to be a beacon of hope for the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of nations, may the Holy Spirit fill their hearts and minds with a thirst for righteousness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are experiencing financial hardship due to the coronavirus, may they find support in the charity of others and not fail to trust in the providence of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here, may God create in each one of us a contrite spirit that is pleasing to him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us come in faith to the Lord, who graciously hears and answers our prayers, especially for Carl E. and Rita Keyes Henson, that they find fulfillment in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's also pray for peace around the world, especially in Ukraine. Let's also pray for peace in our own country, in our local community and our city. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, source of all wisdom, we humbly ask that you hear our prayers and answer them according to your holy will, for we make them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offer tidings, number 396 in Breaking Bread, drawn to you, number 396.
To the beauty of your presence in this
just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, in Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope with the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory, yours now, forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.
all that time in the town. And sometimes even that with funerals, people like yourselves, I told you this before, you know, do your kids know that you want a funeral mass? Because when the time comes, you know, he's died many years from today, do they know that, hey, I'm your mother, I'm your father, I want to be buried in the church. None of this, you know, one day, done, put me in the ground or somewhere like that, and all of you guys are bickering over, like, what's this going to be? You don't have to bicker anymore. I'm your mother, I'm your father. You're going to have a mass for me, and I'm going to be buried in this cemetery, and that's the way it is. So you don't have to fight anymore. Because as soon as somebody dies, it's always like fighting, arguing, what are you? No, I want a mass, and I want to be buried. End of discussion. Or I'll punch it. That's it. Like, good for you, Mom. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Now, may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Have a nice day, everybody. St. Michael.
The archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God rebuke the enemy, mom, we pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our recessional hymn is number 591 in Breaking Bread, Companions on the Journey, number 591.
Ha 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 ha.